Welcome to the 2019 CBC PEI Leaders Debate live from Harbourfront Theatre in Summerside. Welcome. And so let me tonight introduce the four leaders of PEI's four parties. So we start with pick number one, NDP leader Joe Byrne. PEI PC leader Dennis King. Green Party leader, Peter Bevan-Baker. And Liberal leader, Wade MacLauchlan. So Joe Byrne, you begin tonight. You can start with your 1 minute opening statement.
Great, thanks. Thanks Louise, it's wonderful to be here. Thank you all for here and that are listening online and radio. We're told the PEI is working, but I wonder, working for who? It's certainly not working for the thousands of Islanders that are on a wait list for a family doctor. It's definitely not working for so many children that are living in poverty. We can no longer ask people to choose between feeding their children and saving the planet. We either have to do both of these things together, or we will fail miserably on both. We may have some big problems, but the NDP solutions are bold. We can invest in a clean energy economy, creating thousands of good-paying jobs, lifting people out of poverty while reducing our greenhouse gas emissions. We can train the doctors that we so desperately need right here in PEI. And we can have a government that invests in housing so that every Islander can have a decent, affordable, quality place to call a home. Together, we can bring change for the better.
Thank you. Now we'll move on to Progressive Conservative leader, Dennis King.
Well, good evening, party leaders and fellow Islanders. In just a few days, voters will elect their government. So please vote, whatever your choice. Everywhere I have traveled in this province, everyone I have spoken with has a dream for a better future. But many are frustrated. They fear the system isn't working for them. They know the challenges are serious and the solutions aren't easy. But they also know and understand that the best way to reach these solutions is to work together. For me, it's about people. More money in your pocket, getting health care when you need it, a good education for students, and respect for our seniors. We often look at Election Day as the end of a process, but for me, it's the beginning of a new model of cooperation led by a government that respects, listens to, and is accountable to Islanders. That is the government that I want to lead. That is the leadership I'm determined to provide and ready to provide as Premier of Prince Edward Island. I will lead a government that speaks for and works for the people of Prince Edward Island, and I ask for your support. Thank you.
Thank you very much, PC Leader Dennis King. And now Green Party leader, Peter Bevan-Baker.
Well, firstly, I'd like to thank the CBC and Louise for hosting tonight's debate. And it's always a pleasure to meet with my fellow leaders here and to talk about the ideas and the policies and the various visions that we all share for this island. 4 years ago, I stood on this very same stage, and at the same moment in the debate, I said this. I thought Islanders were looking for a couple of very simple and very reasonable things. They want a few good, honest people to provide good, honest government. And I think for the most part, that still applies. I've campaigned from tip to tip during this election. And the one thing that I've heard over and over and over again is that Islanders are longing for change. And what makes this particular election so extraordinary is that for the first time in well over 100 years, Islanders have an opportunity to vote for real, meaningful change, for truly transformative and hopeful change by voting for the Green Party on April the 23rd.
Thank you very much, Green Party leader Peter Bevan-Baker. Liberal leader Wade MacLauchlan.
Thank you, Louise. Thank you to my fellow leaders, to all of you in attendance here tonight or watching from home. 4 years ago, Islanders gave us a mandate to work together to bring positive change and greater prosperity to Prince Edward Island. And together, we have made real progress. Our economy and our ability to care for and support each other have never been stronger. More people than ever are working. And at the same time, we have been able to make historic investments in health care, in education, and in other critical areas like poverty reduction and housing. But there is more work to do. I believe we have the strong and experienced Liberal team that's needed to get the work done for Islanders. I believe we have the right plan to seize this special moment and to move Prince Edward Island forward. Our plan for the future is positive, it is clear, and it is achievable. PEI is working. Let's keep working.
Thank you very much. It is time now for closing statements for tonight. And so we're going to begin in the opposite order that we began tonight, and that will be starting with Liberal leader Wade MacLauchlan.
Thank you, Louise, and thanks to our audience here and to Islanders viewing from home. The election on April 23rd is an important one. It's about our future and about the future of our province. For the last 4 years, I've been proud to serve as your Premier, to lead a team that, together with hardworking Islanders, has built a solid record of real achievement. 77,000 Islanders are working, the largest number in our history. The unemployment rate is at a record low. Our investments in health care, education, and social programs have never been higher. In the first days of this election, we put forward a clear plan for the future of Prince Edward Island. It's a plan based on our belief in Islanders, a belief that working together, a small place can do big things. It's a plan that we can deliver now. It's a plan that will secure our future as we support each other today. The Liberal team is strong, organized, and ready to work starting April 24th. Together, let's keep working. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Green Party leader, Peter Bevan-Baker, your closing statement.
During my opening remarks, I spoke about Islanders' desire for change and for a better future. And they have told me that they want a government with the courage to tackle the difficult problems, the problems like climate change and like poverty. They want strong, vibrant rural communities from tip to tip here on Prince Edward Island. And they want a government that defines success beyond the economic. They want a government that measures the well-being of Islanders, all Islanders, and uses that as the test of whether we are getting ahead or whether the island is working. But most of all, they want a government that has a long-term vision for a safe and a sustainable future and a prosperous future for generations to come. I believe that Islanders are ready to elect a green government. And I believe when Islanders enter the voting booth on April 23rd, they will think not about how their grandparents would like them to vote, but rather how their grandchildren would like them to vote.
Dennis King, 1 minute.
Well, thank you for tonight and for the opportunity to share the stage with my colleagues. We share a passion and a love for PEI, and I admire them greatly. It's a great opportunity to speak with Islanders about the issues that are important to them, and it is a tremendous privilege to be welcomed into your homes and to share in your stories. And as this campaign winds down and as you make your decision, I want you to know that I have the ability and the desire to lead a government that is collaborative and focused on people. I am ready to be your Premier and to lead and work with our strong PC team. We have a platform that is ambitious, affordable, and achievable. Throughout my career, I have been a leader. I have been inspiring people to work with me, not for me. That's because I'm a good listener, I'm a collaborator, and someone who puts peoples and ideas before political stripes and colors. Most of all, I love this province. I would be honored to lead it and to continue to move us forward together. Thank you very much.
NDP leader, Joe Byrne.
Thanks, Louise. Thanks, CBC. Thank you all for being here and listening on the radio or watching us online. The NDP was founded with a combination of labor activists, community activists, church activists, based on a vision, based on a plan that would include everybody. And I know, as the leader of the party, I know that it is absolutely possible to build an island that does include everybody, that includes the plan that leads to prosperity, that leads for healthy, sustainable communities. And so I'm asking you to put a voice at the table. a voice of fairness, a voice that comes with that experience, that comes to say, those that are voiceless among us, those that are most vulnerable, have to be included. Those that are doing well, that's great. But we have to include everybody. So on April 23rd, I'm asking you to vote NDP. Vote for the voice of fairness. Thank you very much.
All right. Well done, gentlemen. You survived.